quick as possible and as clear as possible, so please ask questions. So I'm going to present a work that I have done during my postdoc with Patricia Gonçalves in Rio, and which concerns fluctuations around equilibrium for only one-dimensional systems, which preserve one quantity. So the general context of this model is this system. So take a lattice, and at each point of this one-dimensional lattice, you have a quantity which is eta t of x, which evolves in time, and this eta t of x can be, for example, the particle number as in the talk before, 0 or 1, or in the case of oscillators, on what also David talked before, the position or velocity of some oscillator. Okay, and this quantity evolves in time, but there is a conservation rule. And in the first case, the conserved quantity will be called a density. So this is the sum of this eta x is preserved in time. And I know for this model, I know that there is an invariant measure, which is mu rho, which satisfies that the average of eta of x of one number eta of x with respect to this law is rho. And I'm going to give an example right after, for which the invariance measure is very simple. It is a product measure. Okay. And then, so this is the equilibrium state of my system, but my system is evolving in time. So I have a time evolution equation for the probability law of this sequence eta t of x, which satisfies, so this mu t satisfies a time evolution equation, which is given by a generator L of a Markov process, okay? Which I'm going to introduce an example just after. So take some example in the first case as exclusion processes. So on each point, at each point x, I have particles which are trying to jump. So on each point, put a random clocks, and when the clock rings, at site x, the particle tries to jump on one of the of its neighbor, and a priori the particle chooses the left neighbor or the right neighbor with the same probability, but some jumps are prohibited. In that case, so this is the case of the porous media model. In that case, so the first jump is not allowed because there is already one particle. And there is also another jump which is not allowed. This is this one, because of the fact that, so when x tries to go to x minus 1, the particle looks also off at the particle number at x minus 2 and x plus 1. And if both sides are empty, the particle does not jump. So if there is very few particles on the line, there will probably will be configurations which are going to be blocked because they will not be able to jump, okay? To jump. So if you want to write the rate for the particle at site x to go at site x plus 1, you have to satisfy that there is a particle at site x, there is no particle at site x plus 1, and there is at least one particle or at site x minus 1 or at site x plus 2. Okay? This is the model of the porous media. And this is an hysteristic model because it should give rise in the hydrodynamic limits to the well-known porous media equation, which is a kind of diffusive equation with a nonlinear diffusive equation. Okay. And for this system, I'm going to add a weak asymmetry. So now the rate to choose the neighbors is not equal on the right or on the left. There is a weak asymmetry here, which is given by b to, divided by 2 to the power, n to the power gamma. And I'm going to look at the behavior of this system when n goes to infinity. Okay, the weakly asymmetric version of the porous media model. And for this model, I know, and it is very a very good property of that system, I know the invariance measure, with the equilibrium state is just the Bernoulli probability product measure for which the probability to have a particle outside x is rho, and the probability to have no particle outside x is 1 minus rho. And I am interested, so now the first steps to study this this kind of model is or find the hydrodynamic limits, as I told before, which is a very hard problem in that case. Or, for example, you can also try to look at the fluctuations around the equilibrium state. So what do I mean by fluctuations around equilibrium? So start at initial time with that equilibrium measure, so which is stationary. That means that for any time t, you know the law of the sequence of eta t of x, which remains a new rho. And then accelerate the time on a certain time scale here. I keep for the moment n to the power of a. So I look at the configurations at time t n to the power of a. And I am interested in the probability distribution of the whole process, whole trajectory between 0 and capital T n to the power of a. So, and and the fluctuation field, which I'm going to study, so the convergence of the fluctuation field, this is defined as follows. So you look at eta t n of to the power of x minus its average. So this is you subtract the average of eta t of x. You take the sum divided by square root of n, and try to prove a kind of central limit theorem for this field. Okay, this is equivalent to study the fluctuations or the equilibrium state, which is given by rho in this case. So you know already some free result, which is that for each fixed time, this field, because of the fact that eta t is distributed according to the invariance measure, this field at each fixed time converges to some white noise. This is a consequence of this of the central limit theorem in that case. But I am not interested in the behavior at fixed time, but I am interested on the probability law of the whole process, the whole trajectory between 0 and capital T. So to study this convergence, I'm going to compute the derivative in time of this field. And I didn't write the whole computations, but in the most important part of the derivative is given by the generator L times the time scale applied to this field y of n of phi. So I have to compute this guy and then to study how it behaves when n goes to infinity. And this is going to be now more with more computations. But I hope you will get what is the most important part of the computation. So when you try to apply L to the field, you applied L to eta of x. And because of the fact that there is a conservation law, L of eta of x is given by a gradient of the current. This is a microscopic current from x to x plus 1. Okay? This is given for every conservative model. So in your field, in your in the derivative of the field, when you have L of eta t of x, instead of having the gradient of j of x, you can translate to make a sort of integration by part and put the gradient on the test function phi. And in that case, you gain a power of n in front of the sum. So first, compute the L of eta of x and make an integration by part to gain another n in front of the sum. And the whole point now is to compute this current. So for every class of models that you are going to study and you want the equilibrium fluctuations, the main point is to compute this current. And there are some currents which can be treated with rigorous tools. And the first the class of currents that we can study, for example, are this one. So if the current can be decomposed as a gradient, another gradient, like here we had a gradient, so it will allow to gain another n to the power or something. So the first part is a gradient. And then you have polynomial functions of the configuration eta of x, eta of x, eta x plus 1, and so on. So it is the case of the porous media that I presented before, but it is also the case for other models, microscopic models. You have to compute, yes, because of the rate. So yes, my rates are already polynomial functions of eta of x, actually. So that where that comes from. Yes, exactly. And here there is a weak asymmetry that I put on the rates. Okay. And for these kinds of currents, we can find a nice equation on the field to prove its convergence, and without needing too much mathematical tools. Which are not satisfied for many models in general. So the gradient part, as I told you before, allow to gain another power of n in front of the sum anyway. And after doing this second integration by part, you can use the so-called Boltzmann-Gibbs principle, which was introduced in 84, which allows to replace this new function of eta of x. This is not the same because you have a gradient which you don't know a priori. So you can replace this new function of eta of x minus its mean by something which will allow to close the equation on the derivative. So you have done two integration by parts and you close the equation thanks to the Boltzmann-Gibbs principle. I don't know, Brokst and Rost. Well, yeah, two physicists. And then, so it was used since then. It has been very studied and used in many, many models. And then, if you forget the polynomial part, just the first Boltzmann-Gibbs principle here, when you close the equation, allows you to show that this field, the fluctuation field, converges as n goes to infinity to the solution of an SPDE, which is given by, so the derivative of yt is given by the diffusive part. So in the case of the porous media, this is, you will recover the same diffusion coefficient here as in the porous media equation, plus the white noise times some constant, which is given by the average of the invariance measure here of eta x. Okay. Anyway, so this is the first part of the current which you can solve by the first Boltzmann-Gibbs principle. But then you have to deal with the polynomial part. And for that that part, you have to use the second order Boltzmann-Gibbs principle, which was introduced by Patricia Gonsalves and Milton Jara a few years ago, 2 years ago. And for that part, this is much more difficult. So now, don't be afraid, I'm going to simplify right soon. So now, instead of having this eta of x plus 1 inside the field, you want to replace it by the average of eta of x on some box to the square. So in other words, so forget this computation, just replace the polynomial function in the field with the average of eta of x on some box of size L when L is at the mesoscopic scale. Okay? And if you replace, you do this replacement, you will be able to find another term in the SPDE that I have written before. This second order Boltzmann-Gibbs principle has been proved for the porous media model this year, but to avoid these blocked configurations, they had to add other jumps coming from the simple exclusion process. So they add some small jumps, which are going to disappear in the limit as n goes to infinity. But anyway, they add these jumps to prove the second order Boltzmann-Gibbs principle. Because of the fact that their proof uses a very strong tools in mathematics, such as the spectral gap inequality and many other details that I'm not going to explain. And thanks to these gems, they're also able to prove for any other function which is not polynomial. But actually, we found a way to prove the same replacement only for this kind of function, so only for this polynomial function, without using the spectral gap inequality. And if you can do that in the porous media model, you don't need to add this simple exclusion process jumps, and you can prove that as n goes to infinity, the process converges. So this is not a very precise statement, but the equation that you want to obtain as n goes to infinity is a kind of stochastic Broglie's equation, where you recover the same diffusive behavior as before here, and you add a term which comes from the average of eta of x to the square, and this is so the gradient of the field to the square time dt. So this is not a very well-defined equation because it is related to the KPZ equation. So we have to define in which sense it converges, in which sense we have this equation. But there is a way to do it. And this was defined by Milton and Patricia last year. And so our proof of the second order Boltzmann-Gibbs principle can prove that for the porous media, so in principle, we should prove that for the porous media, without the SSEP jumps, there is the convergence toward this solution for the strength of the asymmetry, which is 1 over 2. And the time scale is a diffusive one. This is n to the power 2. OK, so this was just an overview of what does the Boltzmann-Gibbs principle can give. And there are many other applications of this. So this is the new proof without the spectral gap that we did this year. And we can so apply these results to different models. So for the porous media models, for which we don't have the right tools to apply the original proof, but also we can apply these results to the Hamiltonian oscillators with some specific interactions where the Hamiltonian is given by a specific potential, because we don't have here we will not have the usual spectral gap that we need, and also for example, we can also think about exclusion processes with bounds with rates which are very slow and goes to zero, not zero but goes to zero, and this will be the subject of the talk of Patricia next week, which will present the same kind of result for this specific model. So I think I'm done. Thank you very much.
Okay, some questions?
Yes.
Okay.
I probably didn't understand most of what you said, but
okay.
Actually there is one question that I want to understand. The microscopic model you introduced, it seemed to have a left-right symmetry. As far as the transport was transported.
At the beginning?
Yes.
Yes, but then I okay, then?
This one, yes.
Yes, then I add a weak asymmetry.
Oh, okay, yes, and yes. The Berger's term comes from the weak
asymmetry. Exactly.
Okay, this one,
yes.
Thank you very much.
Okay, so, there is a question.
I mean, there's a work by, I think, Dembo and Lee, who look at, just simple exclusion, but not with nearest neighbor jumps.
Porous media?
We also in the weakly, in this weak asymmetric limit, and they prove, convergence to the stochastic Berger's equation. That's what you do over here, right?
Yes.
And, can your techniques be also applied to their result, or can you extend their result,
so,
or how does... This so is Dembo and Lee.
For which model? It is an exclusion
it's
process?
Simple exclusion, but not...
A simple exclusion?
But not with nearest, I mean...
Ah, okay, with longer...
It's the same type of model, it's just sort of slightly different ways. But they had very strong sort of, you know, particular conditions on the weights. Of course, they also needed that invariant measure is Bernoulli, but they had further constraints on the on their weights. And I just wonder whether with this method,
yeah. So in principle,
you can do much better.
Yeah, probably we with our proof, we just need the current to be written as a polynomial functions of eta of x. So probably the rates, if the rates are on the right form, we will be able to apply some proof. So we need that. We need the Bernoulli, so the invariant measures to be product and Bernoulli. And that basically, and we need also to, yes, okay. So the symmetric part of the generator has to be of exchange type. I don't know, but for the exclusion process it is. So yes, probably we can deal with it.
But just one comment. I think that in the paper of Dembo, they prove the convergence to the KPT, the stochastic Burgers equation, by using some microscopic Kolhoff's transformation, no?
Ah, yes, it's not the same. No, yes. So this is another type of convergence. This is not Kolhoff. This is the convergence introduced by Milton and Patricia with the energy solution, the stationary energy solution to this equation.
Okay. Why in the right at the beginning, the added constraints with respect to the exclusions?
Yes.
Apply porous.
Ah, okay. Okay, so you see that, so the porous media equation has a property that when the density is very low, tends to zero, the coefficient is goes to zero when the density goes to zero, the diffusion coefficient. And here you see that if there is almost no particle, so there will be many sites empty, the dynamics will be blocked. This is actually what happens more or less at the macroscopic point of view. When there is low density, there is no diffusion. And here it is quite of the same behavior. This is the simplest model that we can imagine.
The simplest.
Yeah.
As if you put x plus 1 instead of x plus 2, it is not good.
So x plus 1, okay. X plus 1 has to be, x plus 1, has to be empty if you want to jump from x to x plus 1. So you want to jump from one side to another, and you look at the neighbors of these two sides. So you want to look at another side, two sides after. So if you look further, then you will also get another porous media equation, but with a power law which is higher. So you can also look at further sites, and you will get another type of porous media equations. This is the simplest one.
Good.
Okay, so thank you again. So I think, okay, maybe Abhishek will speak.